how that sounds to the Father when we say to Him, all I want is You. We live in a nation that seems to want to turn its back on God, but there's a people who are crying out and saying, all I want. I'm not. All I want. Because when you get God, you get everything else that you need. All I want.
I surrender.
Come on, say it to him again. We say, we say. Withholding nothing.
Withholding nothing. Withholding nothing. Withholding nothing.
Holding.
Holding nothing.
Holding nothing.
Yes, I will worship you. Troubled times come, and it seems like it's no way to see your brighter day. Lord, I call on you without a shadow of a doubt. Lord, it's you that pulls me out. Yeah, the blessing that you gave. Yes, I'm
God is still in control. But we must first submit to His will. Will you say yes today? Will you say yes to Him?
can't speak for everybody, but he's my Savior. He's my Savior, my Savior. So Lord, I love all the weary, wounded, beaten, battered, and scorned. Here I am, Jesus, I come to you.
Me to the light, show me. greatest lessons that I've ever learned in my life is not about education, not about friendship, it's not about employment, but one of the greatest lessons I've ever learned is that God cares. I wonder, does anybody here tonight know that God cares? Somebody and tell them he cares.
One, two. Praise the Lord. One, two.
Thank you. I just wanted to close out this set with this because I thought about Thomas Whitfield, the song he did. I'm probably showing my age tonight, but this is for my age group. Some of y'all look nice and young, but you got some age on you. Age on you. There was a song the Whitfield Company sang that I shall wear a crown when it's all over. When it's all over. As soon as I get home, all of my tears will be over. All of my struggles, all of my heartaches. As soon as I get. I wish I had a witness here. Lift those hands and yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
I shall wear a crown
when it's all over. I shall wear a crown.
I shall wear a crown.
Yeah.
I shall wear a crown.
I shall wear a crown. I shall see his face.
I shall see his face.
When I'm finished down here,
I shall see his face.
Thank you, Lord.
Face.
When it's all over. When it's all over. Hallelujah. I'm gonna put on my robe. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm going to put on my robe.
And tell
the story.
How I made it over. Thank you, Lord. Through our trials. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Lord. Gonna put on my robe. How I made it over. I'm going. In my life, I'm gonna put on my robe.
How I made it.
okay. No more pain. No more tears. Yes, sir. Hey, hey.
Bless your name, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We honor your name, God. Thank you, Lord God.
Can we stand together? We're about to begin.
Good morning.
Celebration service for Sister Doreen. Giving thanks for her life and thanking him for the years that he has loaned her to us. Amen. Let's go to God in prayer. Father, with grateful hearts we come to you. We ask that your presence would be here in this service. as we celebrate this life and give you thanks. You did say in everything we should give you thanks, because this is the will of God concerning us in Christ Jesus. And we pause this morning to give you thanks. Bless the family, comfort them, assure them that you are with them and that you'll never leave them nor forsake them. And even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you are with us. Bless everything that we said and done here today. Send your angels ahead of us. Prepare the way for us. Make the resting of this saint, God, go unhindered by the enemy. We give you praise for hearing us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
The Lord giveth, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord our God. We're beginning by singing the hymn, Lean In on the Everlasting Arms.
Say, what a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Say, leaning,
leaning, leaning,
I am
safe and secure from all alarms.
The songwriter says you are our strength, and that you give strength like no other. Today we come before you, God, lifting up the family of Sister Nesbeth, because God, you have spoken. You've taken your daughter home to rest. But God, we know the void that is left when you decide to move. And today I present this family before you, God, that you can undergird, that, oh God, you can strengthen, that, oh God, you can move their hearts and their minds to see that your arms and your and that the righteous runneth into it and they can be safe. Let them know that they can call upon that name, and that name can give hope, that name can give strength, that name can give joy, that name can release the peace which surpasses all understanding. So today, Lord, we release them into your hands, and we pray in the name of Jesus that through it all, they would learn to trust in Jesus, and they would learn to call upon your name. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
God bless you. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. At this time, we'll be having our first lesson. It'll be taken from Psalms 23. It will be read by Tessa Williams, her niece.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Thank you, Tessa. At this time, we have a singing of the hymn, Because He Lives.
Worth the living because he lives, because he lives, I can face tomorrow.
Spend a lot of time around her. Faithful woman, faithful woman, faithful woman. At this time, we're going to open the mic to have some tributes. We'll be starting off the tributes with her granddaughter, Jamela Irish. Could you come? But I just ask you, following her, you could come. We're going to open the floor. So we're going to ask you, please just be conscious of your neighbor. Don't be too lengthy. Give everybody a chance who needs to speak. Amen.
Good morning. I'm my grandmother, Doreen's second oldest grandchild. I'm truly honored and privileged to have had her as my grandmother and grateful to have been in her constant loving presence. The love a grandmother gives is very unique. Short on criticism and long on love. My grandmother played a major role in my upbringing, teaching me the meaning of family, reminding me to trust in God for direction, to live and respond with love always, and to be patient with myself and others. She has helped mold me to the best version of myself, and without her warmth and guidance and prayers, I don't know where I would be. I truly admired my grandmother for how selfless of a person she was. She did anything she could to help others and see them smile. Many times, she would wake me 6 in the morning on my day off to let me know she made my favorite porridge, even though I would see it when I finally made my way to the kitchen anyway. But my joy brought her joy. The attention to make my day and make me feel special. And those are memories I hold close to my heart.
I remember teaching her how to send her first text message, and once she got the hang of it, I received many messages with I love yous and prayers all coming at the right time. Nothing compares to having a praying grandmother in your life.
To my dear grandmother, you with me for so many years, and although it hurts that you are no longer here, I know his plans for you were much greater. You've created a legacy that will continue to live on and left me memories to last a lifetime. My love for you will never die, and may you rest in eternal peace.
Hi, I know a lot of you here don't know me. My name is Kevin Allen. We all family here, so I figure y'all should start by knowing me for real. All my family call me Pops. You only can call me Pops if you want family, but back up to Grandma. I didn't write nothing down or anything. Everything I'm about to say is about to come from the heart for real. Like, growing up, I wasn't the best grandkid, and Grandma, she stayed on top of me for real, and a lot of things that, like, it's breaking me down right now that she's gone for real, because nothing's the same no more. Christmas not the same, none of the holidays the same no more. Like, showing up at the house, it don't feel the same no more. Like, Grandma was big on family. We had generations of our family go through that house, and Grandma accepted everybody, and like, Grandma's the reason why a lot of us is even still talking to each other for real. Like, I feel now that she's gone, I feel we need to come closer together again. Like, cause there's a lot of people I don't know. Like, I don't want to be out here on the streets going through things, knowing that my family, I used to talk to grandma about all my problems. I want to be able to come to my family. Like, we need to be more united. It's a lot of people in here I don't even know right now. And that's sad. I feel like I really miss her for real. Like, I don't know what to say. I really didn't write nothing down today, so I don't know. At the end of this, we having a get together at the house. Everybody should please come, because I really want to get to know y'all.
Thank you. I want to say thanks everybody for being here. Anybody who knows Sister Roberts, know Miss Doreen, as know my color, Sister Doreen. So I want to pay my respect in every way I possible can. And also, I just want to remember like this, that smile that she always give me, no matter how long she haven't seen me, for every time she see me from in the past and to the present, just want to remember her smile. And I love thanks.
Praise the Lord, everybody. You know, we honor God today. Hallelujah. You know, as I think back, the first time that I met Sister Doreen, she had just come from Jamaica, and I remember the kids, Norma, Donovan, Junior, Marsha, I can't remember the other guy's name. And in our old church, I remember Pastor telling us that Sister Doreen needed a place. And in the building that I lived, there was an apartment. And I told her, and she took the apartment. So we became close. From that point up until now, I spoke with her a few months ago. You know, and I just thank God for the relationship. You know, I've seen the kids grow up. I don't know the young ones, but I think up to Marsha. And, you know, as I look back, it's so untimely you know, you would see someone, you would talk to them, and you just don't know within a few months what could happen. But I thank God for the relationship that we had. I thank God that sometimes she would cook, and I remember her making these big dumplings and inviting me over. And we just had a really, really godly, sisterly relationship, and I thank God for that. And all I want to say is that, Sister Doreen, see you in the New Jerusalem. Hallelujah. You know, and as the person said before, you know, family is important, and she was a big component of family. So I just want to encourage you guys, stay close together, love on each other, be there for each other, and we would see her again in the New Jerusalem. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. Hi, for those of you guys that don't know me, my name is Tyreek. Norma is my mother. It's been a pretty tough week for me. I lost my grandmother and my friend. It's a lot for me. Christmas, man. That's all I gotta say. It's Christmas. Like, every year we used to go to grandma's house and get together. The fact that I couldn't do that this year, it really took me. Like, I'm not the type of person to really cry, but I cried. It was a lot for me. I cried. I don't know. And then 2 days ago, I lost my friend, sat in the hospital, and I just couldn't do it. It was just too much. Like, all in the same week, I really couldn't. Like, oh man. Like, shrimp, when grandma passed away, I started to think, like, shrimp, I don't even like shrimp. Grandma's the only person that made me like shrimp. Christmas, she used to cook the red snapper shrimp. I used to come and make sure I got that. Like, shrimp is not even my type of, oh man. Sorry I had to bring this back to food, but that's how I get. Man, I just want y'all all to stay close to all you guys' loved ones, because you never know when they're gonna go. Really don't. It made me think, this past week really made me think about life differently. Like, I always been, like, growing up, I always been an outside kid. I'm always outside, and then now I just see my friends go pass away. It makes me think, like, I gotta get closer with my family.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I had to come and give respects to Sister Doreen Nesbitt. Mother Doreen Nesbitt, she is one of the mothers of this church. She's one of the founding members of this church over 25 years. She joined this church and she's been a great part of this church. She loved my mother, Joanne Golson, very much. The 25th church anniversary, we were all outside taking pictures and having a good time. And right in the parking lot in the back, we call it the Spanish parking lot, she pulled me aside and she gave me a card specifically for my mother. Everybody was kind of focusing on my dad, and she took the time to focus on my mom on that particular day. And it really meant a lot. And just last Christmas, she came and found me in the balcony, and I still have the Christmas card she gave us. And I just want to say that she was a giving lady. She was a loving lady. She loved her family very, very much. She loved her church. She loved her community. And that's shown by the love and support that she has here today. And I just want to say we're going to miss her, and we love her. Mother Doreen, God bless you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jackie. Sister Doreen, we call her Doreen. For me, I call her Mama, Mom. I know her since the early 90s, like probably 94. She helped me to raise my two girls right there. Poochie called her Mom. Tina called her Mom, because that's what she was to us. We were strangers, but we were daughters, granddaughters. I once lived with her, so we was really family, and we still consider ourselves family. It just hurt me to know Pooja going through so much missing her because they were so close. I remember she teach me how to cook gungo beef soup because my daughter loved soup, Tina. And I'm gonna really miss her. After I move out the house and I get my car, we never pass her on the road. I said, Mom, where you going? Hempstead. Get in. No matter what, when the corona first started, I saw her, I pick her up. I said, where you going? She said, work. I said, we can't sit down. She said, no, not right now. She said, I gotta make sure my kids and my grandkids okay. She was just a good person. Anybody that comes in contact with her just know that she was mama to everybody. It don't matter who you are, she was mama. And it just hurt so bad. I wasn't able to see her to pick her up. We weren't able to call each other. Nothing. Look at my daughter. Look at her grandkids. We all got memories. We just got to hold on to the memories and live with it and know who she was to all of us that come in contact with her. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Hello? Y'all can hear me? As I said before, I didn't write anything down, so a lot of things just coming back to my head at the moment. And I feel like we gotta start normalizing, checking up on each other because, you feel me? Grandma's gone now. That was our lifeline between all of us, like everybody. And we will always come back, and at the end of the day, that's how we seen each other, through Grandma. Get-togethers, Christmas, Thanksgiving, all that stuff, that was through Grandma. We gotta keep that going on. For real, because I'm far away. Like, a lot of us is far away. Like, I don't live here. I live in Ohio. Marsha lives in Florida. We can't just come and see all of you guys like we want to. So, my thing is, I feel like we should start checking up on each other a lot more. Because you never know. Just like Tyreek, he's going through some stuff right now, too. We don't know. Like, I don't need nothing from nobody here. Money is not, I can get anything on my own. I just need the mental support from my family. And I know a lot of us need it here. Because you never know what the next person's going through. Your life can look good to everybody, but you can still be going through something in your head. And I love you guys. I may not know you guys, but it's love here. And I just want y'all to know that.
Praise the Lord again, everyone. I'm a daughter of the ministry here, and it's as a result of Sister Doreen. She knew a friend of mine and invited us over to church. And I've never left. I was a young single mother, and her helping hands just blessed my life. She didn't just
invite me to church. She invited me to her home. She blessed my life both spiritually as well as physically. And I just want, I empathize with you. I know it's a great loss. We truly love her and we will miss her. But I want to say to those of you who might feel the tug of God on your heart today, as I once did, if you feel that tug, don't harden your heart. Let this moment be an opportunity for God to pull you into the place where he would have you to be in 2021. Don't resist him. Say yes. It gets better and better with Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Sister who lives in Florida, was unable to make it to say farewell to Aunt Doreen. She would like everyone to know that Aunt Doreen and her as a child, they get along together, they never fuss and fight. They spend a lot of time on the phone communicating. And for me and my sister Carly, Aunt Doreen took us in when my mother came to America. And she took care of us. And she teach us how to be loving and caring and sharing. And Aunt Doreen, we're gonna miss you. Rest in peace until we meet again. I'll miss you so much.
I just want to say that Doreen has been in my life for 26 years, and she had just put me underneath her little wing and just made me part of the family. And I've been so blessed for my daughter to have such a beautiful grandmother, and we will just love her always. And I would just miss her long talks. We talk for hours. She always, you know, teaching me how to cook, which was so hard for me, easy for her every day. And how we just always had to say, I love you before we would hang up the phone. So you never know what tomorrow's gonna bring. Always say I love you to that person. And just God bless everybody and the Allen family. And I will love you during forever. You will be in my heart always.
It's overwhelming to hear the tributes of love and how much the life of this woman touched everybody. She certainly had a benevolent heart. She was always gracious to everybody that come in contact with her. And as I sat there, you couldn't help but notice the impact that she had on the younger generation. She was able to leave her mark on them. Whether it be food, whether it be admonitions, whether it be advice, but this woman just had a heart of gold. I know I personally just want to just give a tribute to her because I had to associate with her a lot. And I remember when we started this church, I had to, at that time I was driving the bus and I had to pick them up and sometimes drop them off in Roosevelt, a group of ladies, and she was one of them. And Sister Doreen, she was always encouraging. No matter what it is, she'll always have a word of encouragement that will just hold you. And as we hear, she has been the glue of this family. Hold on to those memories, hold on to the glue. Second generation, don't let it go. That's the value of your grandmother. That's the legacy that you're worthy of. And as I said to Bishop, one thing I always notice, this woman was a hard-working woman. She was a hard-working woman. Whatever she did it with all her heart. She was always conscious about providing for her family. God bless her. I cherish her memories. I speak of the great legacy. Young people, be proud of her. She did a lot. And she left you a lot of lovely memories. So hold on to them in Jesus' name. Amen. At this time, we have the singing of the song, I'll Fly Away.
I'm singing, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
I wonder if you could stand with us. You know, Sister Doreen is gone from our presence, but we have a hope, amen? Come on, stand to your feet. This is a celebration of a saint of God, and I wonder if, in his celebration of our life, if you could put your hands together, let's clap our hands together and sing it together.
Oh, some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away.
Raise your voice and sing it.
I'll fly away. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
Just a few more weary days and then
I'll fly away
to a land where joy will never end.
I'll fly away.
I'm singing,
I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
Oh, I'll fly away,
oh glory, I'll fly away. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
Hey, singing,
I'll fly away.
I'm singing,
I'll fly away.
What a hope. What a hope that we cherish not in vain. You may be seated. At this time, we have the reading of the second lesson by Rosemary Bernard. It was taken from John chapter 14.
add my own few words before I go to the scripture. My name is Rose, for all of you that don't know me. I'm Doreen's last sister. I'm her baby sister. And I just want to say, like I heard my family before came and said, stuff about loving each other. They're right. I love each and every one of you. We might not call each other or might not do it as often as we should, but my sister was a loving person, and I would like to see the love continue, for us to love some more, just to reach out to each other a little bit more, because at the end of the day, we're family. The same blood runs through our veins. We just have to appreciate everyone a little bit more. I love you all. This morning I'll be reading from John 14, verse 27. I leave you peace. I give my peace. I do not give it to you the way the world gives it. Do not let your heart be troubled, nor let them shrink for fear. Amen.
At this time, we'll be having a video presentation as a tribute to her.
Father, carry me.
words of assurance that he will carry you. There is no hurt that heaven can heal. Though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we'll fear no evil, because he's with us. At this time, we'll be having the reading of the obituary by Jasmine Allen.
Good morning. If you don't know who I am, I'm Norma's last child.
Doreen V. Nesbitt, also known as Mama or Miss D, was born on November 27th, 1948, in Jamaica. To her parents, Ruby Lynn Dawkins, an employee at Public Works, and Felix Nesbitt, a carpenter, Doreen spent her early years living in Caledonia on the beautiful island of Jamaica. In 1987, at the age of 39, she made the decision to move to the United States and to live with her father in Hempstead, New York. In order to provide a better life for herself and her children, she began working at a home health aide for various agencies. She then filed for her two eldest children, Norma and Robert. A couple months after their arrival, she relocated to Roosevelt, New York to live on her own. Once she was fully acclimated to her life in America, she filed for all of her other children, Marcia Dean, Kevin, Juliet, Donovan, and Samantha, to come.
In the mid
sisterhood grew until Monica's passing in December of 2016. In 1998, Doreen started working as a nursing assistant at Long Beach Commonwealth Nursing Home. She was a dedicated worker and friend, always showing love more than empathy to her patients. In 2005, Doreen was afforded the opportunity to purchase her first home
in Roosevelt and New York City. This home became the place where her grandchildren were raised and many family gatherings were held. She was the spiritual strength of the family. She made it her duty to instill the word of God into the children and the grandchildren. Doreen has touched many lives by spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ. She also used her home as a safe haven for many people in need.
In addition to her love of church, family, and her community, Doreen enjoyed planting flowers, collecting solar garden lights, shopping at Marshall's and TJ Maxx, and attending her grandson's wrestling matches. She was always on the phone, letting her friends and family know how much they were loved and how much she appreciated them. After living a joyous and fulfilling life, Doreen went home with her Lord and Savior Jesus Christ on December 22nd, 2020. She is survived by her mother, Ruby Lynn Dawkins, her children, Norma, Robert, Marcia Dean, Kevin, Juliet, and Samantha, two brothers, Rupert and Leroy, her nine sisters, Isabel, Hyacinth, Gloria, Maureen, Rose, Stephanie, Colette, Rose, and Joan, her 20 grandchildren, two great-grandchildren, son-in-law, Anthony Garcia, goddaughter Alexis, and her friends Donna, Rachel, Mary, Gina, and many more.
Praise the Lord again, everybody. At this time, we'll be having a special song. It'll be sung by Minister Simone Pierre. This is one of her adopted church daughters. And following the ministry of Minister Peart, we will, next voice you hear will be that of Bishop Barrington Goldstein. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah, Jesus. God, we lift your name. God, we give you glory. We thank you for this life, Savior. Hallelujah. Praise your name. As I lay me down, heaven hear me now. I'm lost without a goal.
winter, giving it my all. Winter storms have come and darkened my sun. But after all that I've been through, who on earth can I turn to? I look to you. I look to you. When all my strength is gone, in you I can be strong. I look to you. I look to you. Yeah. When melodies are gone, in you I hear a song. To lose my breath, there's no more fighting left. Same things arise no more, searching for that open door. 'Cause every road that I've taken has led to my regret. I don't know if I'm gonna make it. Nothing to do but lift my head and look to you. We look to you, Jesus. Yeah. When all our strength is gone, it's in you that we will be strong. I look to you. I look to you. Yeah. When melodies are gone, in you I hear a song. I look to you.
When my love is a
mountain tumbling down on me,
the rain is falling,
the wind is calling,
I need you to set me free, take us far away from this battle. About the Lord, we lift up our eyes and look to the hills. We look to you, Lord. We lift our hands. We lift our hands to you. I look to you. I look to you. When my walls are crumbling down on me, when the rain is falling, when defeat is calling, I need you to set me free. Take us far away from this battle. I need you. Shine on me. We look to you. Together. Hallelujah. We look to you. We look to you. There's no better place to look than where Jesus is. Hallelujah. We look to you. We look to you. I encourage your family. Keep on looking. I look to you. God, we bless you that we can look to you and you will fill us with all good things that we need. Come on, open up your mouth and bless the Lord. He's in the room. Hallelujah. Even in this moment, he's right where you are. God, we thank you.
David said he lifted up his eyes unto the hills from whence cometh our strength. Our strength comes from the Lord which made heaven and earth. I'm happy this morning that together we can look to him. Can we clap our hands and give him praise? Because not only can we look to him, but he's looking over us. Come on, let's clap those hands one more time again. Hallelujah. We bring our condolences and assure the family for our prayers. Amen. The passing of Sister Doreen. Certainly our hearts are saddened by her passing, but in the midst of that sadness, there's still a spirit of rejoicing and thanksgiving, because we know that our God is a great God, and everything he has done well. Amen. If they can just adjust the lights in the sanctuary, I appreciate that. Thank you so much. Praise our God. Greetings to Elder Seeley, Elder Houghton, Elder Stewart. We thank the staff for helping the family to facilitate this process, to all the ushers and the workers that have come to make this service what it is. We give God praise. To all our children, our grandchildren, great-grandchildren, sisters and family members, we greet you this morning in the name of Jesus. And all the friends that are here. My son said it well. Sister Doreen was just one of those special saints. Special in a whole lot of ways. When we started ministry, the thing that drove us was to try and make our lives matter. And we lived by rising to lift others. But as we ministered throughout the years, I came to realize it's not so much doing and extending a hand to help to lift others. It's really about doing life with people. So I shifted the focus of my ministry in the latter years to doing life with people. Because I found out life has its cycles. It has its ups and its downs. It has its good days and it's bad days. It has its crying days and its celebratory days. And you have to be prepared to be in it with people all the way through. And as I sat there, I thought about this family in particular, and I'm thanking God that he allowed us the opportunity to do life with you. Been to funerals with you, we've been to baby dedications with you, been to weddings with you. It's just life. And not only have we been doing life with you, but you have been doing life with us. And we thank God for that. So this morning, I want to lift a thought for you from the word of the Lord. And I trust it will bless you. Sister Doreen will not be forgotten. You heard Minister Simone singing, "I Look to You." She reminded me that Doreen was the instrument that God used to bring her into the house of the Lord, and it shaped her life. Amen. And as a result of that, hundreds and thousands of people's lives have been blessed. Reading the obituary, I again remind the friendship between she and Mother Roberts. Amen. And just wonderful people. Amen.
wonderful people. One passage from the book of Psalms. Psalms 116 and verse 15. David writes and he says to us, "Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints." Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. A couple years ago, reading this, it challenged me. Handling a funeral service and a loved one that passed, it made me reflect on this passage. And just reading it, you would think that God is psycho. No disrespect meant. But the grief that I was going through was so heavy that this passage didn't make any sense to me. How can God view the passing of the saints as being precious? How can he see this as something wonderful when all of us are going through this heaviness, this grief, bearing this weight? And so it forced me to study the text and to understand it better. The word precious simply means costly. And David is saying to us, whenever a saint of God transitions from this life to the other, God sits down, as it were, and contemplates. He deliberates. He thinks consciously about what is about to happen. And it's a high price that he's going to pay when he removes a saint from the earth realm. The scripture makes us understand that the grave cannot celebrate him, and the dead cannot praise him. Doreen can no longer be impactful to her family, impactful to her community, impactful to the church, to her friends. And she can no longer carry out the mission, the vision of God has placed in her heart. She can't be an extension of God anymore in the earth realm. She can't be that encourager, that grandma, that mother, that worker, that saint. So for him to remove her, he contemplates. He thinks seriously that this is going to cost him a witness in the earth, a praiser in the earth, a giver in the earth, a worker in the earth. So when he does that, it's costly to him. He pays a high price. Last night I stayed up to develop this thought even more. And I found six other reasons that I'd like to lift and leave with you to consider. The time is at hand, so I'll try to make it brief. Number one, God sees Doreen's death as being precious, costly, and he took her because he found out in death he now can be the God that can supply all of her needs. Not just her needs in the earth realm under the sun, but her needs for eternity. Hallelujah. I don't know how you feel about it, but the physicians have done all that they could. The family has done all they could. She has done all that she could. Now it's up to God to supply every need that she'll ever have, because she's not in the body anymore, but she's still alive in the spirit. And there is needs that she will have that only God now can supply. Can you say hallelujah? And we can celebrate God that we saw his hand of provision while she was with us. And we need to have faith now that he's supplying the needs that she has on the other side of glory. The second thought I want to lift: death is precious in the sight of God, costly to him, and he allows death to happen in this case because it creates for him an opportunity for him and him alone to have a more intimate communion with Doreen. Glory to God. She spent her time here communing with him as often as she could, interrupted every now and again by work, interrupted every now and again by situations. But now he has found a way for her to live in his presence forever and to enjoy constant, perpetual worship before his throne forever and forever. Glory to God. I'm so glad that the Lord took her so that she can be with him to worship and bless his name forever. The third reason, amen, we find is that God has decided that Doreen on this side of heaven every now and again would take a nap, sleep 7, 6, 5 hours sometimes even less. But he decided through death he would give her eternal rest. That's what Jesus meant when he said, come unto me all ye that labor and are heaven laden, and I will give you rest. He gave her rest on the earth realm. Now he's giving her rest eternally. And that's a good reason for us to clap our hands and celebrate, because this hard worker has gone home to rest, and to rest eternally. So while our hearts are heavy on this side, let's not rob her, amen, with grief, and by not giving God thanks that he took her and gave her rest forever. Not just rest in the day, but rest for eternity. Can you say amen? Paul, John writes in Revelation 14:13, he says, I heard the voice from heaven saying, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works do follow them. I stand here this morning excited that Doreen has found rest. You and I have to keep on working, take a little nap in between. But her work is over. Her labor is over. She's gone on to her reward, and she's enjoying eternal rest. In Hebrews chapter 4, Paul writes, there remaineth therefore a rest to the people of God. Hallelujah. For had they have entered into his rest, and they now cease from their works as God did from his. If you recall, when the Lord created the heavens and the earth, he did so in 6 days, but on the seventh day he rested. Doreen has finished her work days. She has punched out for the last time, and now she's resting and giving God glory and praise forever and forever. The fourth reason I thought about why God views death as being precious and why he took Doreen is this: death means abundant life. Glory to God. In John 10:10, John writes, he said, the thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus said, I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. Glory to God. He gave her his spirit, filled her with the tongue talking Holy Ghost, which was a seed, amen, of the eternal life to come. And she carried that spirit with her in a temporal body that prohibited her from enjoying eternal abundant life with God. So now he put the body to rest so that she can have abundant life with him. If you thought she had a good life on this side, amen, wait till you get over there and see the life that she's enjoying right now. I believe we can put our hands together and give God praise that Doreen is enjoying the best life ever. Glory to God. The house in Roosevelt, the cars, the grandchildren, the hair, the clothes, the shoes, the good food, all those things were good. But nothing is being can be compared now to the glory that's being revealed in her. God has given her abundant life, and now she can rest. I read a book a couple of years ago from the Scottish preacher and poet, James Burns, and he wrote these words: I've been dying since I was born. Now I'm dying to keep on living forever. We all on this side of heaven, we are in the land of the dying. Doreen has gone home to the land of the living. That ought to wipe the tears from your eyes. The day we were born, we started to die. Glory to God. So God had to give her rest and that abundant life. She is now in the land of the living, where there will be no more tears, no more work, no more dying, no more heartache, no more sickness, no more COVID. She's going to be living forever and forever and forever and forever with her Lord. Hallelujah. That's a good place to give God praise. Amen. Death to God means joy. The Bible constantly exhorts us to rejoice forevermore. God wants his children to have joy. But how many of us can realize that even this life, as sometimes it's joyous and pleasant, there are moments when it's heavy, it's problematic, it's grievous, it's difficult, and if we're not careful, it robs us of our joy. He decided through death to give us joy everlasting. Hallelujah. You'll never see Doreen sad again. You'll never see Doreen in pain again. You'll never see Doreen worried again. She is now enjoying joy everlasting. I feel for that we can give God praise for death, for her death, because she's enjoying joy forever. And it should give you hope that if God has done that for her, he will do that for us. So while her passing from this side causes grief, we have a confidence that there's going to be joy in the morning. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. The last point I thought about last night is this. Death means God creates an opportunity for ministry. And I was moved by the young man that was speaking, and he said that because of this situation, we are gathered together. God knows that every now and again, he needs to put a pause into a busy schedule so we can come together and begin to value each other and appreciate each other. Death of our family and friends often leads us to invite the man of sorrow into our homes, into our lives, into our schedule. It slows us down, and death reminds us that we're not here forever. And while we're here, we need to value and appreciate each other. The departure of a loved one opens a window in heaven and gives us an opportunity to think about the heavens beyond. Say amen. By leaving us, listen, I wrote this last night. By leaving us, they, in a very true sense, come to us. It makes us sit and not take for granted everything that she has done. It makes us sit and bring back the years to our memory. And the beautiful thing about a funeral, most times, if not all times, we discount the issues and remember the blessings. We realize the value of the person's passing and what they mean to us. So for that, this morning, we thank God for allowing this to happen, knowing that He knows best. Say amen. Also, their leaving us offers us an opportunity to come together. May the coming bring us joy to know that all is not gone. In the casket is one. In the sanctuary, there are many. We have reason to celebrate. God did not take everything from us. He took one. And before He took her, He sat down and He weighed the cost. And He said the price He was willing to pay. So now that she's gone, now that God took her, He's expecting that you and I that are remaining will continue the work that she has started. Amen. Continue to love each other. Continue to care for each other. Continue to put the cause of Christ at the top of your agenda. Because only what we do for Christ is ultimately going to last. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of His saints. Let's pray. Father, we bless You for Doreen's life. We thank You for her children, her grandchildren, her great-grandchildren, her brothers, her sisters, her relatives, her friends, not only that are in the sanctuary, but around the world, wherever they are. We thank You for them. Thank You for her life. Thank You for the impact that she had. Thank You for making her a difference maker. In the name of Jesus, we celebrate her passing. We give You praise and glory because You're helping us to understand that You know what's best. And I pray now, God, as they go through this grieving, that You will not leave them, but You'll put Your arms of comfort around them. You who stood by Lazarus's grave and wept because You felt the pain of death, You understand what they're going through. Now walk up to them and let them know it's not over. This is just the beginning of a new life for her. And what You have done for her, do for them, I pray. Those that are here that don't know You yet, in the pardon of their sins, in the power of Your resurrection, in the fellowship of Your suffering, never tasted of the goodness of Your salvation, reveal Yourself to them. Make Yourself known to them, I pray. We give You praise again. We pray now our legacy will continue. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's stand together and repeat the Lord's Prayer as our funeral director comes. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Let's do it together. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done. Give us this day and forgive us as we forgive those. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everyone. On behalf of the family, I'd like to once again thank you all for coming out this morning to be with them during this time of bereavement and celebration. Thanks to all the congregations and organizations represented, especially the family here at Calvary. Thanks to everyone who came forward, your tributes and reflections. Very special thanks to Bishop Goldson and all the other ministers and everyone who's lent their kind words of comfort and encouragement here to the family. Minister Stewart and our musicians and everyone who lent their voices to bless this service. I know the family greatly appreciates you. Immediately following the service, you will be going to Greenfield Cemetery. Those of you that are traveling your private cars, we ask you please follow the hearse with your headlights on and four-way flashers as we proceed to the cemetery. So once again, please follow the hearse with your headlights on and four-way flashers. I believe at this time, we'll be having a final viewing. No? Okay. So we'll be just having the final blessing, and then you will be dismissed to go directly to your cars. You can follow the family out during the recessional. We'll have an orderly sessional. You can follow the family out to your cars. Some may have the benediction. So we can have the recessional. Thank you.
While you remain standing, we need to take your things with you. And the pallbearers, can they come? Kevin. Robert, Lanny, Aloy, and Dwayne, would you come? Elders, would you go before? We're going to ask you just to remain in your seats. And ushers, if you direct us from the front, the family will go right behind the casket with, led by the elders. You come out in the center aisle, so stay right where you are, and they'll direct you up. But take your things with you, please. Amen. Father, we thank you again for this opportunity. We close this service, this portion of the celebration. We pray your journey and mercies to go before us. We thank you for all things. In Jesus' name.
Is called up yonder, when the roar is called up yonder, when the roar is called up yonder, when the roar is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roar is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, Lord, I want to be in that number. When the saints go marching, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, Lord, I want to be in that number. When the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, Lord, I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in.
I'm singing by and by when the morning comes, when all the saints of God are gathered home, we will tell the story. We will understand it better by and by.
I'm singing
by and by when the morning comes, when all the saints of God are gathered home. We will tell the story how we overcome.